to you, withholding nothing, withholding nothing. I surrender all to you, everything I give to you, withholding nothing, withholding nothing. Come on, you say it.
Computer, and you wanted to do something else and don't do what you wanted to do.
Okay.
Am I the only one in here that experienced stuff like that? You cut a piece of them, but you put the cursor or the mouse cursor, you know, on it to drag it down to cut and paste something out, but it don't go, nothing happens. And then a few minutes later, a few seconds later, it pop up it got a man that's got a mind that I want to do it. I'm saying, I wanted you to do it when I wanted to do it. You know what I mean? In other words, that tells me every time those kind of things happen, that it's some kind of virus or something has taken over my computer. And usually when those things happen, what I do is I run up my virus, antivirus, or malware check, and try to get and see what's going on, and try to delete it. And when that doesn't work, I call the Geek Squad. The Geek Squad go in, they get on the phone and get in my computer, and they clean up everything. They just wipe stuff out. Now, it's some stuff that they wiped out one time that I really wanted. All right. But look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, if it's infected, you might as well get rid of it. If you don't get rid of it, it's going to affect your own operation. So I realized that I needed to get rid of that thing. You know, it's amazing how, as a society that we are today, that we are so intelligent and we're so smart, and yet at the same time you can be so dumb. Let me say that again, because I didn't go well. You know, as a society, we are so smart, we're so intelligent, but we can act so dumb. Yeah, help me. Look at your neighbor. Maybe I think he's talking about you. Let me pay attention. Come on. I couldn't talk about you being the smart one, or I couldn't talk to you about being the dumb one. Either way, we are affected by it. They tell me that there's a virus that can affect your body and mess you up. And the Center of Disease Control, CDC, they tell us to talk and teach us and share with us about viruses, those kind of things that affect the natural body. And not that I'm trying to be a scientist or be so smart and astute in learning about viruses, but one of the things that I do want to have a grip on is the things that can really affect me. And when I looked at the word of virus, it says, I found out what a virus is. It says a virus is a tiny organism that causes an infection in the body. So it's something that's not necessarily designed to be in the body. And if it is designed to be in the body, in some kind of way got infected. Look at your neighbor and say, don't be affected.
By the wrong thing.
Because here, viruses are made up of little genetic material. No, we call it DNA and some call it RNA, which is a virus used to replenish itself. And that's what doctors do, scientists do. They take diseases and take sickness, and they take those diseases and sickness and they create some kind of vaccine or some kind of thing that would cause whatever it is to be eradicated, or your person can get healed from it. Watching a picture one time, and here it was an outbreak, and this was based on a true story. Ebola. Somebody said Ebola. Ebola is a disease that infects the body, and here I found in watching and listening to this particular true story that 2 out of 10 will live from it. And then they worked on it in 2018 and they found out how to get it cured. not only with Ebola, but HIV. Man, it's so prevalent in our society today. Hepatitis B, and I'm from the old school, amen. I've been around a minute. West Nile virus and malaria. Pastor was telling me about a pastor friend of mine, man, that went to Africa on a crusade. And while he was in Africa on a crusade, preaching his little heart out. Here, when you're in Africa, you can't just drink the water. Somebody help me, some parts of it, because you can get malaria. And so he was preaching, he had his bottle of water, he was safe, but he set his water down. Somebody picked it up and drank a little some of his water. And he drank behind me. True story. And he caught malaria. So when he come back to the States, he's got to continue, amen, to take treatment because he contracted malaria. Somebody say malaria. It affected his body based on him drinking the water. That's why I'm glad to have armor bearers that bring me a bottle of water. Sometimes I go to places to preach. Well, let me just say this, not sometimes. I don't do that no more. But I remember distinctly, I was up on Jersey Avenue, this little small church, and we went there to celebrate, lift up the name of the Lord. And it was hot as firecracker in there. Somebody help me here. And so you know, Jan, when it's hot, you will drink some water. And I don't know, and this was before I got into armor bearer, somebody watching out for me and looking out for me, and they brought me some water. And Pastor Nita, I drank the water up fast after I finished preaching because I was hot. Somebody said hot. And usually when you're hot, you get that water down, right? And I got that water down. And Virginia, when I looked at the bottom of the glass, saw that orange juice stain still sitting in there. From then on, I don't drink out of glasses. So y'all can buy all the pretty glasses you want. For the pastor to drink out of, I'll drink out of that one. I won't drink out of here. Because somebody got to wash that glass. And some people don't know when you wash the glass, when you set it up like this, whatever's in the glass going down to the bottom of it. So I couldn't drink the dishwashing liquid. Somebody help me in. Some diseases are airborne, and you can catch them. You know, I remember when the Hong Kong flu, did I got any witness in here? Bird flu. Y'all help me, y'all. I got y'all looking at me like, y'all. When flu season comes, it's amazing. When you start getting older, this is for young people. When you start getting older, they're going to start requiring you to get certain shots. Now, you got to get the shots before you go into school. When you get older, when I say older, I mean you start getting 50 on, you have to start getting some more shots that you got when you was a little kid. Yeah. Huh? Yeah. And y'all help me.
That's right.
Huh? And so when you start getting those shots, they're not giving you those shots necessarily because you got contracted some kind of disease. They give you those shots to ward those diseases off, to block them off, to stop them from coming. In other words, after he was getting ready to leave and get ready to go up out into heaven, he opened that understanding so that all the things that he was teaching them, things that he was sharing with them, things that they saw him do and demonstrate, they realized and they said, okay, now help us to understand everything that we saw and what we're supposed to do. See, not only do you need to know what you see and what you read in that scripture, receive Jesus in your life as your Savior right when you're sick. I'm a firm believer that if somebody can lay hands on you, you can receive the Holy Ghost. I'm a firm believer that the Holy Ghost can fall on you. Somebody help me here. But it's nothing like when you sit down and you get around the altar and you tarry and you wait until the Holy Ghost come upon you. And when you got the Holy Ghost, you know it. Don't nobody have to tell you. The power of God within there, when it gets in your life, it affects you. Mothers used to say, old people used to say, things I used to do, I don't do no more. Places I used to go, I don't go no more. Somebody help me in this way. When the Holy Ghost get a hold of you and you get in, somebody say in. Oh, you ain't no in. You get him.
Yeah.
See, what happened was that some people got in. What's that thing? Vape. Yeah. For what?
I don't understand.
Someone said, well, you know, you can't find that in the Bible. I know you can't. You can't find it. You're crazy if you go on and, you know, but when I found out, I learned how to read a little bit. Mm-hmm. And the Surgeon General said, this fool, this thing gonna kill you. It is a hazard to death. That's the surgeon, that's the chief doctor of this United States. That's what he done said. The chief doctor said, fool, this is gonna kill you. But people will infect themselves with it. And they'll get to the place where they allow themselves to get added to it. But Pastor used to tell, she don't tell me, but she used to be testifying sometimes and say, hey, you know, he got saved that Wednesday night and he just stopped smoking. Instantly. Now, I wanted to be the first to say that wasn't the only thing I stopped. Amen. And there were some still things still hanging on. Somebody said, still hanging on. See, we think that we can live 40 years in sin and all of a sudden be squeaky clean. The devil is a lie. See, you still got stuff. You still got baggage. I wish I had somebody that lost weight. Mm-hmm. Yeah. That weight just didn't drop off. Someone help me here. You're 200 pounds and you come out of the gym after you have worked out, you're still 200 pounds. You got to keep on working out. Come on, here, somebody help me here. So the things that you know that you're struggling with, that means that it don't mean that you don't have the Holy Ghost. It means you need to be delivered. Yeah. Come on. And what I found out, deliverance, it already belonged to me. It's a promise that's already in the scripture. And for me to get it, that means it's something that I need to do. What do I have to do? Well, I got to lay aside that. That's a weight. Some of us need to be delivered from eating. Some of us need to be delivered from running our mouth. Some of us need to be delivered from doubting God. Some of us need to be delivered from these false prophets. Somebody help me in this way. Deliverance doesn't necessarily mean you all out there in sin. Because if your mind is messed up, your mind is twisted up, fertilize it with the word of God. this plant.
Okay.
And they were all hanging over and drooping.
Okay.
And I know why they were drooping. There was two reasons why these plants were drooping. One of them is because they didn't get enough water. Huh? Second is because they don't get enough sunlight. Come on here, somebody over here. And some of y'all are not hanging around the sun. You got to know how to tell yourself, hey, amen, I'm going to do the right thing.
Right.
Listen, you broke, you t- And if you expect God to bring you a man, oh, you sadly mistaken.
Amen.
Someone said, well, but I want to get married. Then you got to pick one. Not the woman pick the man. That's a foolish thing. Huh? Why is it foolish? Because it's out of order. It's the man. He that finds the wife.
Uh-huh.
Someone said, well, how do you find a wife? Well, number one, you need to look like you want to be a wife. Oh, God.
She'll tell you, I got 47 years out of James, you know.
You don't want to preach here, man. But you can find somebody worse than me.
Amen.
You can. You got some folks out there that's great. So I'm the best thing to slice of bread. but you have to learn to live right. And she learned how to tell me that.
Amen.
And every now and then I learned how to listen to it. First, she tell me. Second, I learned how to listen. Third, I try to start doing it. See, knowing it and don't do it don't mean anything. Don't mean anything. You can quote all scriptures in the Bible. You don't live that long.
Withholding nothing, withholding.